When I first was offered the position at Motown, one of the privileges I had was to be able to meet Mr. Gordy at his home. And one of the first things he showed me was all this amazing footage he had from the early days of Motown. He was genius enough to record every A&R meeting, every picnic, audio and video footage. And he captured the beauty that existed then. And when the CEO of Capitol, who Motown is a part of, and I had a chance to go to the house again, we looked at each other and we were like, we have to make a film. And we were pretty relentless in the project. It took about 3 to 4 years. It just happened to all come together and be able to release it during the 60th anniversary this year. But it was important to tell the story and acknowledge the foundation of how it got created, because it wasn't easy. His level of resilience and focus on the music and the songs and the quality of the artists, it's really unique, and I think that it's inspiring for so many people to realize, like, that group of people coming out of the inner city of Detroit in, you know, 59, the impact that they were able to have. I think it also reminds you of the value of music and how music really brings people together. So I'm proud that that gets to happen. I think it's also inspiring for a younger generation to know that that happened, you know what I mean? So I'm proud.
Can you articulate for you what the true magic, the spirit of Motown actually is?
Now, that's a good question. The spirit, love. I think Mr. Gordy will tell you that. There was a lot of love built there, and that's what kept them going. That's what created the resilience, a love and a family dynamic, but a love for the music, a love for each other. A love for the work ethic and not giving up, and they believe in each other so relentlessly, you know, they never gave up. And I think it's important to know that it's never over until you give up, and so they kept that family unit together. And you hear stories about Diana Ross and the Supremes and how long it took for them to get a hit or whatever. In today's times, it's kind of hard to imagine a label sticking with an act for that long, but when you believe in something, you don't let up and you focus on it. And I think they represent that resilience, love, belief in yourself. I love the moment where, you know, Barry built a company based on him working at a factory and that process. But I love when he talks about the story of him and Marvin and the What's Going On album, and how he was a little afraid of, you know, kind of pushing the envelope and having a controversial album, or what he perceived to be controversial, but it was honest and authentic to where Marvin was, and he created this beautiful album that resonates with people even today, you know. And so I think him having to evolve from having that kind of factory mentality to understanding artists sometimes just have to have a voice and have to be able to speak their truth and how it really connects with people. And that was a good teaching moment, I think, for a lot of people. Himself and Marvin and the whole team. So
the time when the industry is transforming beyond all recognition, what are your hopes for the future, not just of the music industry as a whole, but specifically of Motown and the beautiful legacy it represents?
I think our goal, no matter what, is to develop great talent that has incredible songs that will, again, connect people around the world. I think it's limitless opportunity now. I think it comes down to the quality of the music. I think streaming has created an even playing field for all talent, so it's like the best of the best has to rise to the top. But the work ethic and the quality of the work is definitely what's most important now.